Hey, want to hear a few clever riddles?
Sure, hit me.
All right. What gets wetter the more it dries?
Sounds like a trick. Is it a sponge?
Close, but nope. It's a towel. It dries you off, but it gets wetter in the process.
Ah, clever. Okay, what's next?
What has a bunch of keys but can't open a single lock?
Keys that don't open locks? Oh, is it a piano?
Nailed it. You're getting the hang of this. One more, what belongs to you, but other people use it more than you do?
Is it my phone?
Nope. It's your name. Everyone says it, but you hardly ever use it yourself.
Whoa. That's true. These are fun. Got any more?
This will be a quick video about a project called ChatterBox, a text-to-speech generator that creates speech based on a sample audio you provide. The sample can be of any person. The setup is pretty straightforward if you have Pinokio AI installed on your computer. If you've recently faced an issue like a blank discover page in Pinokio, check out my previous video. I've shared a quick temporary fix for that. Now, inside Pinokio, go to the Discover section. Head over to Community Scripts and search for ChatterBox. This is the project. Just click the download button. Pinokio will automatically fetch the required dependencies. Click install, and it should take care of the rest. You might get a dialog box with yes or no options. I will click yes. That was for the Visual Studio installer. The installation might take a while since it downloads large files, around 8 gigabytes in total. Once that's done, the application will be running inside Pinokio. First things first, I like to switch to dark mode from the settings. The interface is clean and easy to understand. On the left, you type your text. On the right, you upload your sample audio. This can be your own voice, or even that of a well-known personality. Just make sure the audio is clear and should be longer than 10 seconds. There are a couple of basic settings, one to adjust expression and another to tweak the speech rate, useful if you want the voice to sound more thoughtful or deliberate. Below that, you can name your output file, which is a nice touch. Once generated, your result will appear here. I then started looking for some sample audio, which should be clean and could be recognizable by the viewers. It took a bit of effort, but I found a few decent files online. After uploading the file, you'll see some details about it below. It was a fairly long clip. I then pasted some example sentences into the text box. At this point, I realized my screen recorder wasn't set up to capture audio, so I'll just play the downloaded result instead.
Thank you, Klaus, very much. It's a privilege to be here at this forum where...
I only played a short snippet. YouTube's copyright detection is pretty strict. I named the file test1 and clicked generate. The hardware usage was very low. I think even a system with a 4 GB GPU should handle it just fine. It took a little under 2 minutes, and I got the final result. You can download and save the output from here.
Leaders in business, science, art, diplomacy, and world affairs have gathered for... Hello, this is a test of the ChatterBox text-to-speech system. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Welcome to our AI-powered voice synthesis demonstration.
The quality was fine. From my point of view, it is 8 out of 10. You can tweak the settings further to get it even closer to the original voice. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. I searched for another celebrity audio, Dwayne Johnson. I uploaded the audio file and tried generating audio based on my text.
My Tinder bio says that I have a corner office with views of the entire city, drive a 500,000 vehicle, and that I'm paid to travel. My dates never seem too happy when I tell them I'm a bus driver.
So it is a bit unclear when he said, with views, and I should have written dollars instead of dollar sign. I decreased the expression, and this is the result.
My Tinder bio says that I have a corner office with views of the entire city, drive a 500,000 vehicle, and that I'm paid to travel. My dates never seem too happy when I tell them I'm a bus driver.
This time the pronunciation, with views, was clearly audible. Overall, it's better than before. I lowered this value, and this is the result.
My Tinder bio says that I have a corner office with views of the entire city. I drive a 500,000 vehicle, and that I'm paid to travel, but dates never seem too happy when I tell them I'm a bus driver. My Tinder bio says that I have a corner office with views of the entire city. I drive a 500,000 vehicle, and that I'm paid to travel, but dates never seem too happy when I tell them I'm a bus driver.
It definitely gives you control, but you'll need to experiment a few times to get the best results for your use case. Thankfully, the generation process is quite fast, though it does depend on the length of the audio sample and the text you provide. For example, a sample file that's around 160 seconds long gave me results in under 20 seconds. I wrote a conversation between two persons, named as Person A and Person B. Then I uploaded a sample audio of Elon Musk and all the conversations of Person A.
Hey, want to hear a few clever riddles? All right. What gets wetter the more it dries? Close, but nope.
For the conversation of the Person B, I used the audio file of Joe Rogan. I pasted the conversation of Person B and clicked Generate. Now I have audio conversations from both people.
Sure, hit me. Sounds like a trick. Is it a sponge?
And you must have got it now. Let me know if the video was helpful.